as a project manager, that's one of the key goals that I have, is to really sit down with the owners and develop what the overall goals are and then design a model that is in alignment with those goals.
If we have an accurate model, we can minimize change orders. By no means we're going to eliminate change orders and errors in the field. That's always going to happen. But our goal is to minimize that and catch that early on.
They're able to see where these potential problems are before they become problems. And usually if you can do that, you can find solutions that aren't going to cost you money. It's going to save the owner money. It's going to save the owner time.
It does speed up the production effort, and then it also speeds up the actual construction because the contractor's armed with more information than just a set of drawings.
We're actually able to give them that three-dimensional model that they can continue to use through the life cycle of the building for facilities maintenance, for tenant improvements. They can use it for renovations that they may do to the building down the road.
With all the attention these days on environmental considerations and energy consumption, BIM lets us simulate a lot of these building systems and changes in the design, and we can analyze the performance or the cost or the energy usage, and that's a big deal to clients.
We were actually able to change different R values and U values and skin, exterior skin of the building, and see what effects it would have on the energy consumption of the building in real life.
BIM really is creating an opportunity for us to do the projects a lot more efficiently.
At that point in time, I realized the power and the strength of the tool. It's then proven its worth again and again